Well, 16 years ago, we were introduced to Kenny, the portaloo cleaner with a heart of gold.
I think it takes a certain kind of person to do what I do, and it's just about having a thick skin. No one's ever impressed. No one's ever fascinated with what you do.
Are you doing your job here? What's going on?
We are.
If you have a tool, you have to have paper. Do you understand?
We do, mate. I'm sorry.
There is a smell in here that is going to outlast religion.
So I don't do it for the glory. I don't do it to impress people. It's the job.
Look at that. Hey? What kind of curry's that bloke been eating?
And now Shane Jacobson is swapping the Dunny brush for the hair brush. He'll be starring in the upcoming production of Hairspray, taking on the part of Edna. And Shane joins us now. Shane, such a pleasure to speak to you. This is the part that John Travolta played in the Hairspray movie. It's the role of an overweight housewife. Can you tell us about Edna and its tradition of being played by a man?
Yeah, mate, it's always been played. It was written for a man to play the mother role and has been done so every time it's been performed. But the truth of it is, what I love about it is that John Travolta did it so, so well, and that's what I plan to do, which is he played the part of not a man wearing a dress on stage. What he did was he played a loving mother, and I think that's one of the parts of the role, if you will, that I love the most, is my job is to not have people look at me and go, there's Shane Jacobson in a dress on stage. I want them to see me as the loving mother, because Tracy, who plays my daughter, the character Tracy, I think the reason, if you've watched the film, which me and my family watch semi-regularly, I'd love to think she gets her confidence, as so many kids do, by hopefully having a loving mother and father at home. So I think that's my job in this musical.
Oh, I can't wait to see this. There's some great songs. And you've also got a couple of big dance routines. How are those moves coming along?
Yeah. Yeah, well, are you asking me or are you asking my wife and kids? I think I'm going to go all right. Because I've still got my kids going, oh, Dad, please tell me you're not going to dance.
Your moves.
Well, if it's going to upset... Yeah, if it's going to embarrass you, of course I'm going to do it. Look, the dancing stuff, I tap danced for 2 years when I was a kid. I used to dance as a kid. So, no, I can't wait. But I've got to dance in heels. Wish me luck.
Yeah, that's it. Now, you're used to being on the boards and in the musicals. Are you looking forward to getting back on stage?
Yeah, mate, you know what it's like. Yeah. The great thing about performing live is, again, as you know better than most, is that the audience is right there in front of you. You know, your nearest audience member is only one orchestra pit away from you, a couple of metres away, and, you know, you get to see their faces respond to what you're doing. And as soon as you finish the song or the number, you get applause straight away. And I just can't think of anything else. You know, film, it can take a year until you've left set, until it gets delivered to an audience, and you're not in the cinema to see their response, for the most part. And the same with TV. If I do a TV role, I might get to sit there and watch it with my wife and my kids, and I can assure you when it... you know, cuts to an ad break, my kids don't stand up and applaud. So that's the great thing about theatre, is they're right there and it's immediate. And I love it. I started on stage at 8. Actually, it was about 8:15, but who cares about the details? But no, I was 8 years old when I started. So it's my happy place.
Oh, and you know what makes us really happy? The Kenny movie. We mentioned in the intro, it's been 16 years. Would you ever revive the character for a movie sequel?
So we did a TV series called Kenny's World, where we travelled the world. Mm. But it's that thing, it's been that long now. I pulled on the overalls once at the 10th anniversary of Kenny. Was also the 20th anniversary of Shine, and it was the 30th anniversary of Crocodile Dundee. So me, Paul Hogan and Jeffrey Rush did an appearance together, and I came back on stage just for one night. But it's funny, it's been, I always said we'd probably never revisit it, but it's funny, 16 years is a long time, so, you know, what are they saying? Never say never. So, you know, I'm not saying watch this space, but I am saying, they do say never.
Yeah. That's great. I think there's something in that.
I hope so, yeah. Now, Shane, you've been up at Bathurst last week. You love your cars. And you're doing a series about the great Aussie rivalry, Ford or Holden. Where do you stand on that one?
So now that I'm going to be narrating it, I think it's I love them both. Now the truth is, look at me, I'm playing both sides of the coin. Now the truth is, I actually own Fords and Holdens, so I'm kind of more amongst the motoring set. I'm probably you know, more known for being a Holden fan. So I do have a, you know, HQ Holden, a HJ Kingswood. So look, I've got some Holdens, there's no doubt about it, and a HQ Ute. So, but I've also got a ZD Fairlane. I just purchased 2 weeks ago an F700 Ford truck. So I do literally have Fords and Holdens in my collection. So. You know, I was a Holden fan when they were competing against each other, and then when Holden's brother Ford left Australia, as did Holden, as far as Australian manufacturing, my heart broke for both. So it's okay to have two bands you like, you know what I mean? And then my two favourite bands were Holden and Ford when it comes to tarmac. So, you know, I miss them both dearly. So I'm so thrilled to be narrating this, you know, it's a feature documentary. I can't wait. So it's in my blood, but I can't wait to spread the virus.
We love it when you talk
dirty. That's a bad analogy. Why did I say spread the virus?
Pandemic or something that's been happening in the past couple of years. You can catch Shane in Hairspray in Melbourne from August. All the details at hairspraymusical.com.au. Shane Jacobson, you're always such a pleasure. Thank you for joining us. We'll catch you soon.
Thank you. Pleasure.
Thank you. Bye. Take care.
See ya.